Stellaris has new additions to the Humanoid Species Pack in Dev Diary 220. So there are a few new Civics, Masterful Crafters, Pleasure Seekers. Then we come to the focal point, the Clone Army Origin. That is an origin that adds a great story and a challenge. You will play clone soldiers left by their masters. Let's go step by step. So we have Masterful Crafters with a penchant for meticulous crafting. So artisans are replaced with artificers. Artificers produce one more consumer goods as well as two trade value and 1.1 engineering research as a difference to artisans. Every three industrial districts too, this grants one building slot except on habitats. So you'll be able to specialize your people much more for consumer goods. So if you want, you can have a really, really good consumer goods planet. And this Civic also goes very, very well with the next Civic, Pleasure Seekers. This society rejoices it in its own perfection and is a little bit wasteful because it allows a decadent lifestyle living standard under which all affected pops have increased happiness and consumer goods upkeep. So you could use the Masterful Crafters to have no problem with the Pleasure Seekers. And the Pleasure Seekers' main thing is pop growth from entertainers increases pop growth by 1%. So you could have one of these recreation holiday planets and you could stuff it fully with entertainers, and then you will have a very, very high pop growth from these planets. So you can have effectively pop growth planets. Like, these will be holiday love-making planets. Also, servants produce 5 additional amenities. It does not work with warrior culture, shared burdens, or slaver guilds, for obvious reasons. And there is the decadent lifestyle, as you can see here, prioritizes more resources and luxuries for privileged members of society. And privileged are also the workers, but not the slaves. You can see here, rulers will have 1.1 upkeep, specialists not 0.5, but 0.55. upkeep, and workers not 0.25 but 0.27 upkeep in terms of consumer goods. So this is exactly, I think it's roughly the number by which the production of this is amplified in consumer goods. So these two fit so well together, you should make something that works that way. So in addition, the entertainer job will also grant the 1% pop growth, and that we've already seen, 5 additional amenities for the servants' pops. Here's an example: to entertainers, 2% pop growth. There is also a mirror version for mega corporations for the pleasure seekers, of course. And then we come to the clone army origin. A species of short-lived and infertile soldier clones, exceptionally proficient in matters of war, left masterless and alone to question their engineered purpose and uncertain fate. You start with 2 ancient clone guard buildings on your homeworld producing clone soldier pops. So you have a different kind of pop. It's clone soldiers. They have some different traits. As you can see, ancient clone guards have an empire limit of 5, so it's a challenge. Clone army admirals will grant an additional 25% ship fire rate and 10% reduced ship upkeep. So will these find another species they could take care of, they could lead? Because you won't have too many of the clone soldiers. What do you do when you outlive your usefulness and your creators? That's the question you can dive in in the clone army origin. Your empire will be perfectly suited for warfare, even though you may not currently have any enemies. Your lives and continued existence will depend on your ancient clone vat buildings, which support the population. So that's a clone soldier. As you can see here, it has governing ethics attraction plus 50%. Leader lifespan minus 40 years, so they will die very, very quickly. And an army damage increase of 50%. Cannot be genetically modified, cannot produce reproduce naturally. So that's gonna be crazy. How will they survive? Leaders from these species have additional traits and bonuses. And yeah, there's a limit of the ancient clone rats. It's 5. We have seen that above. That's an example of an ancient clone rat. From the start, like at the start you get 2 of these buildings and later you can build 3 more. So you have monthly organic pop assembly plus 7, which is kind of good, I think, produces and sustains clone soldier pops. The effectiveness of this growth is reduced as the ancient clone vat reaches capacity. So, you will have a number of problems. You have a very limited population, and you have a limited way to increase the population. And the question is, what do you do with this? You cannot genetically modify your people, but maybe you can become robots. I don't know. Maybe you can adopt another species. Now, you could be a good little clone soldier and simply wage war as you were designed to, or you could dive into the secrets of your own history. That choice will be left to you for every playthrough. You can also combine clone army with both masterful crafters and pleasure seekers. So, pleasure seeking clone soldiers? All three of these additions are not portrait locked. Some have ethic or competing civic restrictions. So, that's gonna be very interesting to play that way, especially with a clone army, but also the combination of pleasure seekers and masterful crafters is certainly very intriguing. So, thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. We'll see each other in another video. Have a great time until then and happy gaming. This is Immanuel Can signing out. See you soon and happy gaming.